You were thinking, wow, this sounds tedious and not performance conscious if exokernel has to validate the key every time for the library to use it. Well, it depends on what we mean by a resource. Let's look at some examples.
Here is an example of a candidate resource, a TLB entry. TLB entry is going to establish a mapping between a virtual page to a physical page. That mapping of the virtual page to the physical page is done by the library. Now, once that mapping has been done by the library, it presents the mapping to the exokernel along with the capability or the key, the encrypted key that it has for a particular TLB entry. Exokernel validates it and puts this mapping into the specific TLB entry of the hardware TLB. Now, this is a privileged operation. Putting an entry into the hardware TLB is a privileged operation. The library operating system cannot do it by itself because it doesn't have the same privilege as exokernel. And therefore, once that capability in the form of the encrypted key for this TLB entry is presented to exokernel, then exokernel, on behalf of that operating system, is putting that mapping that has been established by the library operating system into the specific TLB entry of the hardware TLB. Once this entry has been put into the TLB, the process that is going to be using that virtual page when it is running can use this multiple times without exokernel intervention. So even though putting it into the hardware TLB required the intervention of exokernel because we are messing with hardware, once that entry has been put in, that entry is on behalf of this library operating system, and processes of that library operating system, when they are running on the CPU, can access the TLB and do the translation any number of times because all of that is happening under hardware control, and exokernel, of course, is not in the middle of any of that. So that gives you an idea of how, even though we are saying that in order to do certain things in the hardware, you need the exokernel help for the library operating system, the normal use of a hardware resource is not going to be in any way affected by the fact that exokernel is in the middle between the hardware and the library operating systems. Here is another example of a candidate resource. Let's say that the operating system wants to install a packet filter that needs to be executed every time a network packet arrives on behalf of a library operating system. Predicates for looking at this incoming packet are loaded into the kernel by the library operating system. Now, this is a heavy-duty operation because you're doing it with the help of exokernel. But once those predicates have been loaded into exokernel by the library operating system, on every packet arrival, exokernel will automatically check it using those predicates. So those are examples of candidate resources that tell you that establishing the binding may be expensive, but using the binding once established does not incur the intervention by exokernel, and therefore it can happen at hardware speeds.